says yes. Yes, yes. My soul says yes. Yes. Yes, my Lord, my soul says yes. Yes.
Sisters and brothers, it's good to be in the house of God this morning, isn't it? We all beat the cold to get in, right? Brothers and sisters in Christ, when God called your name, God called you to a journey of faith, do not be afraid to look inside to see those things which are holding you back from being who God created you to be. Place your trust in God, who is always with you, loving you in wholeness. Wait for the Lord to be strong. The promises of God will never be broken. With Him as our light, what is there to fear? The promises of God will never be broken. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. The promise of God. God of promise fulfilled, we gathered as descendants of Abraham. We stand before you as faithful testimony to your covenant. We assemble as living proof that your love for humanity knows no limits. When we feel overwhelmed by the stresses of daily life, we need only to look at the stars in the skies to remember your abiding faithfulness. When we are overlooked with despair by the pain of war and poverty in our world, we need only to see the light of a single candle to remember the one you sent as our light, our strength, and our salvation. We pray now in the name of that light, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. We'll move on with a musical selection from our sanctuary group. Again, don't let me remind you, it's cold outside, so let's get warm inside by standing up and praising God.
Take over this place, take over this place. Sweet Spirit, take over this place, take over this place. Sweet Spirit,
Sweet Spirit.
Take over this place.
Mighty Spirit.
take over this place.
Take over this place.
How many want the Lord to arise in this place?
Amen.
And take his place.
Yes.
We enthrone you with our worship. And we come to give you praise. Arise, O God. Arise, arise,
O God,
and take,
and take your place.
We enthrone you,
we enthrone you with
the worship,
the ancient nation,
to give you praise.
You are good,
and your mercy,
and your mercy endureth forever.
Arise, arise.
endure forever. I don't know about you, but I'm glad I'm here today. We'll continue with reading of the scripture from Reverend Watson, 1 Samuel 30, 1 through 8, then 16 through 19.
David and his men reached Ziklag on the third day. Now the Amalekites had raided Nabab and Ziklag. They had attacked Ziklag and burnt it, and had taken captive the women and everyone else in it, both young and old. They killed none of them, but carried them off as they went on their way. When David and his men reached Ziklag, they found it destroyed by fire, and their wives and sons and daughters taken captive. So David and his men wept aloud until they had no strength left to weep. David's two wives had been captured, Abinoam of Jezreel and Abigail, the widow of Nabal of Carmel. David was greatly distressed because the men were talking of stoning him. Each one was bitter in his spirit because his sons and daughters. But David found strength in the Lord his God. Then David said to Abiathar the priest, the son of Amalekite, bring me the ephod. Abiathar brought it to him, and David inquired of the Lord, shall I pursue this raiding party? Will I overtake them? Pursue them, he answered. You will certainly overtake them and succeed and rescue. Verse 16. He led David down, and there they were scattered over the countryside, eating and drinking and reveling because of the great amount of plunder they had taken from the land of the Philistines from Judah. David fought them from dusk until evening of the next day. None of them got away except 400 young men who rode off on camels and fled. David rescued everything the Amalekites had taken, including his two wives. Nothing was missing. Young or old, boy or girl, plunder or anything else they had taken, David had brought everything back. The word of God for the people of God.
Singers.
Come on and clap your hands and give the Lord a hand praise. How many know the Lord deserves all the glory? He deserves all the praise.
You deserve all of the glory.
Deserve all of the glory.
You deserve all of my praise.
You deserve all of my praise.
That's right.
You deserve all of the glory.
You deserve. With my hands, with my hands, with my mouth,
worship God. Giving honor to your pastor. Once again, an opportunity to be with you this morning. Though it's cold, okay, we're pressing our way. I think we warmed up a little bit. Last time I was with you, I could barely talk. But God is still good. And his mercy endures forever. Thank God for you, sanctuary singers, lifting up the Lord and lifting up his name. What do you do when the bottom falls out in your family? What do you do? Eternal God, we thank you for your grace that is always sufficient. In our weakness, your strength is made perfect. So we thank you that you are right now, God. We give you all the praise. We give you all the honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. When the bottom falls out in our family, in the text this morning, David has been running in the wilderness for about 30 years. Now keep in mind, God had called him as a young man to be king and to be a leader. And he finds himself in the wilderness being chased by King Saul, who he's supposed to replace. It's been 30 years now, God. What's going on? And some of us sometimes feel like that. What kind of ways God is taking our lives? And how does this have to do with what God has called me to do? And so David would run from him in the wilderness, and here we are. But I want you to know this morning that God was building David at this time. And sometimes we tell God that it doesn't take that long. And God said, yes, it does. It does take that long, and I know what I'm doing. I know the plans that I have for you, and that's to prosper you and to give you peace and to do you no harm. And so God was building David at the time, and two things the Lord was teaching David in the wilderness. One was God was giving David a warrior's heart. We need a warrior's heart. Sometimes as it relates to our families and to our communities, sometimes we want to give up. Sometimes we don't want to show up. And if we show up, we're just showing up. We're not giving nothing. And sometimes God has to give us a warrior's heart, and he builds that warrior's heart not to be discouraged. I am with you. And as he told Joshua, wherever you put your foot, there I'll be with you. And then Jesus says, seek ye the kingdom of God and all this righteousness, and I will add all these things to you. So wherever you put your foot, it was God's kingdom is at. And so God wants to give us a warrior's heart. Second, God was building into David a dependence on him. There were times when David could not go on, and he would look to the Lord. There were times when the odds seemed to be impossible, and David will look to the Lord. Sometimes we have done so many things so many times that we begin to depend on ourselves. And sometimes you see that God has put you in situations that allows you, only thing you can do is depend on God. There's a message I always tease my wife about. She preached last year. I don't know if I told you about this. It was called Look for the Rainbow. And so every time we get into a crunch, I don't see nothing. And I tell my wife, I said, just look for the rainbow. I laugh because we have the parsonage here, and we have a parsonage place in Ridgefield, Connecticut. It allows me to travel back and forth to here and to the city of Manhattan. And we was coming back from church here, and I have a master, English Mastiff Rottweiler. And I have a hound, and the hound is the one who always instigates things and gets the Mastiff going. And so I'm tired. I pull up in the driveway,
and I popped the trunk by mistake, the BMW trunk, because it's a hatchback. I popped it by mistake, and out they run. And so there was a lady that was jogging. You can see what's going, right? There was a lady that was jogging, and it's not funny though, but I had to look for the rainbow. There was a lady that was jogging, and my hound seen her, and all the hound does is instigate, bark. And so the Rottweiler said, "What's up? What's going on? Somebody's bothering us?" And then they seen the jogger and chased after the jogger. And you got this big black English Mastiff coming at you. And so me and my wife is telling this person, "Don't run. Don't run." And so the Mastiff was like, "What am I supposed to do? Should I bite her?" And unfortunately, my dog did bite her. Yeah. But one thing, it was an opportunity that my wife would minister to this lady in the middle of the street. She was having trouble with her son who had cancer. And she needed prayer at the same time. So they exchanged information. And I had forgot when my dog got this rabies shots. And I said, "We in trouble now." I said, "Let's see how the rainbow, let's look for the rainbow." So we finally got the dog back. She called the police. The police came in, took a report. Then they called me the next day. I said, this is not too bad. We just need your recent rabies shots. So I asked my dog's doctor, I said, "Can you show me my recent rabies shots?" The rabies shots were expiring the next day. Look for the rainbow. And so I said, "Look at God." My daughter was all messed up. Look for the rainbow. I said, he said, "You're okay. If you didn't have those rabies shots on time, we would have to put your daughter to sleep." So that's another thing. So my husband reached out to my wife and said, "We have some medical bills and we need to, talk about some expenses." And so my wife panicked a little bit, just a little bit. I know she's going to beat me up for telling this. And she said, You need to talk to my husband. You need to talk to my husband." So I said, "How you doing, sir? I'm sorry. We apologize. I'd like to pray with you, blah, 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 blah." He said, "No problem, but we have some expenses. I'm going to mail it to you." I said, "No problem." He sent me expense for guess how much? About $1,000, right? $400. And I said, "Babe, look for the rainbow." She said, I thought he would try to sue us and all this. I said, "Look for the rainbow. We always tell, make sure you tell me that and make sure I tell you that. Look for the rainbow." And so not only did I give him $400, I gave him $500. And then we just communicate. So every time, make a long story short, so every time we find ourselves in a situation, we don't try to fix it. We try to look for God in it. What are you trying to say? And so to stop, we stop ourselves because the emotion kicks in and you get very emotional, right? As we see in this text, I'm going to show you. Get very emotional about it. So we stop and we look at each other. Look for the rainbow. And every time God shows up, every time God shows up. When the bottom falls out with your family, look for the rainbow. God would never fail you. So David needed to have a dependence on God, that he will always know what God brought him to, he will bring him out. So here we have David gets back to Ziklag, which is where his family's camp and his soldiers. He finds that the Amalekites had come in and destroyed his camp and took his families, his sons, his daughters, his wives, and everything. And the men that were with him, they took their family. They burnt down their camp. So here you have this guy who was supposed to be a king and a leader, a family man, watching over the people, and he allowed them to come in. What kind of God do you serve? Why should we follow you? Look what happened to us. This happened. And it was so devastating that men began to want to stone him. In today's English, they wanted to murder him. They wanted to murder the king, the leader, because they were so emotional that they lost their family and they blamed it on David. But the Bible tells us the first thing David did was strengthen himself in the Lord. You can't strengthen nobody else until you strengthen yourself in the Lord. And David encouraged himself. How do we encourage ourselves in the Lord? Remember who, hallelujah, remember who you are. Remember who you are. I don't want to tell too much, but I was not a good boy. And I think I told you many, many, many Sundays ago. But where I'm at now is only by God. So when things happen in my life as a leader, and maybe some people want to come against me, it's okay. I still love you. They come against me. I stand because I didn't call myself. God called me, right? So here I go with this situation. Here I go with this issue. Here I go with this decision I got to make, and to make it for the people, make it for my family. God bless me with this. So God is going to keep me with this and help me to sustain this because God is my helper. God is my helper. Remember who you are. Never diminished the fact you are worthy that Christ died for you. That's a whole lot right there. Jesus demonstrated his love for us when he died on the cross. That's it. You demonstrated your love for me because I couldn't get up on the cross. But Christ demonstrated his love. And some of that takes cultivating and meditating. A lot of you do that already and doing it through the Lent season of cultivating that love that God has for you. Remember who you are. 1 Peter 2:9 says, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, are a peculiar people, a special people. Next is remember who God is. Remember who God is. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13 tells us, there has no temptation taken you but such as common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above your able, but with that temptation will allow a way to escape that you may bear it. So when you meditate on that scripture, it says there's no temptation. There's no temptation overtaking you except that which is common to man. But God is faithful. He will never allow you to be tempted beyond which you are able. Isaiah 54:17, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. God said it. That's it. And every tongue that shall rise against you in judgment, thou shalt condemn. 55:1, this is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, says the Lord. Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. David inquired the Lord. In other words, David didn't have a strategy to accomplish his mission. He had been a warrior. He had fought many battles, and he took time to inquire of the Lord to find out what the Lord would say. But when you do it in God's terms, victory will come. The enemy was defeated. Whatever took the family will fall. The family was recovered, as we read in the word, and David got everything restored back to him because he did it God's way. He asked God. So let's get started. God restored the relationship back as it was. This morning, you may want to lay a family before you, a friend before you, before the Lord this morning. And if you have done things that take your family down or took your family down the wrong road, it's time to turn to God now. This we must encourage our hearts and hear our God. This is important. We need to rely on the Lord and be sensitive to His Spirit when it comes to our family and community. Keep an open mind and an open heart. Many times, it's our living before people that makes the difference. David pursued, fought on God's terms, and then seen the favor of God. Every head bowed. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. God, we thank You this morning that we can trust You one more time. With this, we bring forth our family. We bring forth our nuclear family. We bring forth our community family. We bring forth our church family. We bring forth the family members that we may be alienated from and separated from. It may be minute, it may be distance, maybe unforgiveness, maybe our wrong. This morning we give it to You. We bind every Simon that is against our family, and we release the spirit of oneness and love, that restoration and reconciliation may be given. Move in the heart of Your people today. We thank You and we bless You. In Jesus' name, amen.
I learn when your bottom falls out, hone in on David and remember why God take him to where he was. It's because he had a warrior's heart, and because he depended on God to solve his issues, and that we should always look for the rainbow and remember who you are. Who God is, that we should always rely on Him. Thank you so much, Reverend Watson.
It's an honor.
I don't know about you, but I've been blessed. And I'm glad I came out in the cold, because now I'm warm. I'm warm in the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. We'll continue with a song from the Sanctuary Singers. I'm going to ask you that you stand up and let's praise God on our way out. Let's raise our voices and let Him hear it and open the doors of heaven and receive us this morning, because He needs to hear us.
Anybody looking for a blessing from the Lord this morning? I mean, you really need Him to do something for you.
Come on.
Amen.
Do it.
The offering box is at the back of the sanctuary. On your way out, you can leave your collections. And we do have, for those people who are with us at home, we do have the online option where you can actually go online and submit your collections. And you can also mail it. Thank you. Let us pray. Faithful God, you have kept your promises to us. Our lives give witness to your abundant blessings. May we faithfully keep our promises to you. Strengthen our commitments to live as true disciples of Jesus Christ. Your love sustains us, guides us, and empowers us. Take these gifts as a sign of our promise to give ourselves completely into your care, to live without fear, to trust your love without reservation. Amen.
Whatever you do in this season, God, don't do it without us. Let us pray. Be strong in the Lord. You can walk in God's ways, for God is with you, offering you peace, hope, courage, and joy. God's love abides with you always. Go in peace. Amen. Be safe, everybody. It's still cold as I don't know what out there.